Hello, friends. The year is 2023. The month is November. What does it mean? It means that near the end of the month, we're going to have the Rally of the Tall Pine. Arguably, the most challenging event in North America, one of the best rally racing events in the world. And guess what? Last time I did it was in 2019, so 4 years ago. And this year, I just couldn't stay home. But guess what? I don't have a rally car I could enter, because my beloved Disaster is being used as a test car and it's lots of fun. It's working amazingly at Race Lab, but the specs that we changed, you cannot enter it without lots of mods, which you don't want to do just for one event in order to convert it back to a test car after. About 2.5 or 3 years ago, we were approached by a gentleman called Jonathan Starks, and he was selling his Ford Focus, a 2000 Ford Focus that we bought back then for a school car. The chassis on that car is a very well-built one, but he didn't have the budget for a fast engine, so engine, transmission, and suspension in that car is very, very basic. So we ended up getting it as a school car, but never got to actually get it to run it at the Race Lab yet. So here I was in November 2023 saying, I'm gonna enter the Ford. And Can-Jam, my team for and family for like nearly 20 years, they don't really like working on Fords. They can, but they just prefer Subarus and all-wheel drive powerful things. So I talked them into it, and we're entering Tall Pines in a 102 horsepower Ford, and I think it has 106 torques. This is gonna be a blast. Pedals, which looked very sexy but didn't work for my height. The new pedal, work in progress. So here we are, spending a Saturday night walking a transmission on the leash. That's our spare transmission. Okay, so we're going through absolutely logistical craziness now. Not only because this Tall Pines was gonna be okay, we're just gonna go low-key with my buddy co-driving and pretty much no mechanics, no spare parts, etc. And that's still the case. We have my friend co-driving. We are not bringing any professional mechanics, but still you wanna bring some things that we just don't even have, like a tarp, like jack stands. Does the car have jack holes? We don't own a tarp. Do we have boards? No, we don't. Like this kind of stuff, you know, it's just so much. But not only that, also we knew this before. We have a big military training with Race Lab right after Tall Pines. So to prepare all the equipment that we have for both the rally, and we're taking 7 vehicles plus the client's vehicles to this military training at 2 different locations, 2 sets of pylons. It is crazy. And Tyler and Dwayne, and of course you will watch this later, but we just finished all this crazy talking, calling about all this equipment. And I was gonna say that while it's crazy, it's still so exciting. We can pull this off. Like, what we can do is amazing. And this is with all the constraints that we have, like that everybody or most of us have day jobs, etc. So I'm just so proud of us. We are awesome. What a team we are. We are awesome. Thank you guys. Thank you everybody so much. I mean everybody, even students who are not even involved with the team, like Rod Jones was trying to help with the rally safe, and Bruce Leonard as well. And I mean, awesome. So Gary and I, we dropped off the transmission. We picked up the shocks, the hot bits. And thank you, Peter Riley and Can-Jam, big time. This is all happening Saturday night, and Skitty Gitty.
Yes.
He's gonna take them to Peter Riley tomorrow, so we'll see what we can do. Tall Pines summer or Tall Pines winter? I think summer this time. Gravel! The 100 horsepower will do us good.
Skitty Gitty, what are you doing? Are you stealing my radio?
Yes, I am.
These Jamaicans.
Well, what we're doing is we are connecting some fancy push-to-talk buttons that would connect, that would make our nice encrypted radios to be able to connect all the way to helmets, headsets, intercoms for rallying, all kind of beautiful Reiki things.
So someone just asked me, do I regret that I'm putting so much effort into all my crazy rallying prep, all the just everything driving related that I do? And I was telling them, and after I stopped explaining, I just felt so happy, and I was explaining that I love what I do. Like the fact that I can just say, okay, I want to do that rally, and 20 people start pushing really hard to help me make it happen, and they love it too. I mean, like Chris from C17 Media, designing the pace notebooks. So many people, everybody's trying to help with the prep of the front wheel drive car. Like, don't even have time to list everyone, we'll do it separately. But point is that like 7-10 different people, even outside of Can-Jam, are helping with the front wheel drive car. Then the shop, then all the race lab people who are gonna help with the following military training we have right after Tollpies. People who are gonna come to the event itself. It's just so awesome. I really, really love what I do. It's so awesome, so grateful I found this calling early on in my life. So yeah, what a feeling. So good to be doing what you love.
Okay, still the same day. I haven't slept yet. It's 2 or 3 p.m. I just had to do something. So I'm really curious how to remember to drive a front wheel drive car. So I came to the farm. The beauty of these automatic school Subarus is that you can, with the flick of a switch, turn it from all-wheel drive to front-wheel drive. So I just did a couple of laps in all-wheel drive and it's muddy. You can't push it everywhere because we're gonna chew everything up. So it's very selected areas that we can go. So I just did that. I'm gonna try now to go in a front-wheel drive mode and see what I can do. Gotta avoid the line in some places to, again, not chew up the road. This is still awesome. Even the chance, the opportunity to do this. Big thank you to the crazy owner of the crazy farm. Okay, let's do this. From now, so we're gonna cut that section out. Well, am I living the dream or what?
Mud, paying the price. Hi, this is a random cut in. 4 a.m., I haven't slept yet. Which stage is it playing? Comment below, and if you get it right, you might win something.
In the meantime, if Ricky starts so early that we need lights. Look, we got some extra lights.
If people only knew how much work goes into going fast. Just wanted to show you some bits about pace notes. Like, this is just a sample from some pace notes we trained this year on, earlier this year. And then this stuff is all prep for Pines. A couple of three new books, which we're gonna rewrite things into, the notes that I previously made, but we wanna clean them up and rewrite properly. And look, how many more books. This is all getting copied. This is just the four Tollpines books, just the recent, most recent pace note system. That's gonna have to be rewritten, checked with a bunch of videos, with tons of videos, discussed with the co-driver, underlining, all adjusted, like, just so, so much stuff that goes into this. It's pretty crazy. That's the neat version, but still will be rewritten into the rally book. Lots of work, but lots of opportunities to make speed.